if they don't expel him from school? Will he understand? Will he be exposed to the information of cryptocurrency? Never, never. Someone like 50 Cent, would they have the information about cryptocurrency? It's because when he heard about Bitcoin, and he said the best thing he can do is to make sure that he sells some of his album on digital currency. And today he's a millionaire again in crypto world. Information you did not take advantage of, you become a victim of it. And every information you take advantage of will take you to another location, another level you must occupy in your life. Don't always forget, anything you do is a decision. Either you know it or you don't know it. Coming to this place is a decision. When you come here and you start listening, it's a decision. You can decide to distract yourself. You can decide to be shouting. Who will drug you for that? Nobody. The information, the era we are, is the era of information, where everyone has no right to be poor again. Era where no more, nobody has rights to be poor. That you don't have anybody to assist you is no longer it. That you don't have enough capital is no longer it. That you are not too is no longer an issue. If you are the professor of our time, it is good for you. The more you know, the better it is. One thing I want you to always have at the back of your mind is if you should take advantage of some of this information we are sharing here, your life will never remain the same. In the course of my discussion with us today, I will challenge you to our very own hand. Because naturally, majority of us are so complacent. We are so cool, we are so docile. We believe we are making progress because we don't have any track record. We don't know we are not making any progress. Why? How can you be in the midst of information like this and not be making progress? Please, I am of the opinion that if you have been attending a meeting for the period of 6 months, you should be doing well by now. You should be a giver, not a taker, any longer. And to God be glory, some people make it real in their life. From this little meeting. So I am very, very glad. I am so happy. But am I saying this? There are no people in this place or no persons that have not turned their life around to be this world. Based on what the level of their own information. Mr. Dare, Mr. Assis, yeah. And the likes, everybody in the divisions, I want all of you around, yes. Mr. Matthew Alco, Dr. Coyne, possibly. I will be calling from across. Mrs. Princess. I just want to point out to few of us. If you say you've not made good money in this business, it's according to your own input. Hello? There is no two way about it. You can't eat your pain and have it. Everybody, I want everybody on stage. You can't eat your pain and have it. Dr. Pine, please come around. Madam Princess, your attention is needed among few. Prosper, we need you. Okay, you are doing live video too. It's okay. What of Mr. Assis? Your attention is needed. Daddy, you are around today. Come around. The reason why I am calling upon some fewer people is this. So that you will know how to really assess yourself. You won't know, maybe you are making progress if there is no any assessment. Now, I want all of us to look at this set of people I call upon. Not because of anything. I call upon them anytime, any day they answer. And I am one of I am like sons to them. You should can see. Is it that you want to compare or anybody here? But still, they know what they are getting. Information. Information does not tally with maybe I am old or I am young. Now, Daddy joined us, I think, 2017. Do you know how Daddy knew about TBC? It was divinely arranged. From one, someone met with him. Sorry, can I borrow your glasses? And he borrowed the person's glasses. After that, the person introduced TBC to him. And that was the end of it. Like then I played, he attended some of our seminar, and here you see. One thing I know Daddy for is he's always ahead of everybody. In the night, majority of us are so close and we say we cannot do this, we cannot do that. Daddy, as old as he is, he will be reading blog. He will come in, Mr. Ahmed, director. Have you seen it? He will be the one to remind me. I said, I have seen it, sir. I have posted it on the group. He said, I know. There is no way you can proceed without adding value to yourself in the area of information. That is about Daddy. If I should allow Daddy to talk, more than 2-3 times Daddy has addressed us in the hall today. How will you lead us last without knowing more than them? You must learn. Your readiness to learn. The reason why majority of us are not successful is simple. We know so much that we cannot apply. That thing you know, if you should apply it to your life, you will not remain the same any longer. Look at Mr. Aziz. Mr. Aziz joined us last year. You will not believe that the guy that introduced him to the meeting is part of us. He happens to be my church member. And this guy introduced Mr. Aziz and fall back. Mr. Aziz is now a leader in TBC, in Payama, and so many other businesses we are into. The difference between them is application of what two of them are exposed to. Do you think there will be no challenges for him to get this far? There's no obstacles for someone. There are 1,000,001 obstacles. Look at this man. I don't know, maybe any man can be as much desperate, more than this, Daddy. Mr. Matthew, family you are. The first day Mr. Matthew entered into this hall, he told me, I want to use my car to do TBC. I said, are you alright? I was thinking it in my mind. I don't know, maybe he was scary. I said, sir, go and think about it. He said, I don't need to think. The first day he entered to this meeting, he said, you don't need to think. You don't need to think. I said, sir, why would you think? Go and think about it. Have you considered your wife? Have you considered this? He said, it's my car. I am using it for TBC. I said, okay. Sir, I am driving the car. And now we finish our seminar. I'm going to church. I cannot drive the car together. What you will do for me is take this car home, bring it tomorrow. I thought he would not come back. The following morning, he called me. He said, you want to bring the car? I said, I'm gone. I've gone to another seminar. He said, what will you do? I said, you should call me back later. I was thinking, he didn't really mean it. Because it is huge for you to just come to seminar once and you are convinced enough. Lot of analysis lead to paralysis. By the time you keep on diagnosing the information and take it to friends and family that are no lesser than you are in the business, what do you think they will tell you? By the time you blind man, you now come to a doctor, you open one of your eyes, and you now go back home and go and meet your blind friend. You have one eye now. What do you think your blind man will tell you? You are blind. He will tell you there is no way in that place you are going. I will be the one to lead you. The man dropped his car as I think he dropped the car. He entered this place from 16th of August 2017. Eventually, the third day on 19th of August 2017, he brought the car to my doctor. He said, Oga, I'm at your doctor. I want to do this transaction. Test.